to give a closing argument. Let's hear from negative sample, speaker number 4, Harvey.
Fellow Toastmasters members, most welcome guests, appoint Madame Comte's chair. Let me rephrase this. Should we lie to our children? If you put anything else, if you take Santa out of the equation, I'm pretty sure that everybody here will say, no, you shouldn't. But let's bring the old party kind out. He's such a nice fellow anyway, right? He will mess up with our hair and let us sit in the lab. He will bring a lot of presents that we will leave under a Christmas tree. But the bottom line, the question remains, why? Why do we want for our children to believe in something that is not real? Is he some kind of demigod that we are picturing here? Because if he is, in a very near future, you may hear something like, if there is a near city by you which doesn't believe in Santa, let put it through the soul. Because that will be a dogma. Is that something that we want to have in our children? Children that are not able to think by themselves? Is it true? Is it really true that we need magic as a natural process of growth up? Is it? We really need to our children to, instead of having critical thinking and creativity, to be put up in believing magic things? Is it really necessary? Is it really a stage of development? Children are in their genes encoded to believe in what their parents tell them. And that's a huge responsibility from their parents. You don't want to put that trust in risk. Because little lies, very little lies, will start hurting, will start breaking that bone of confidence that they have for us. And that's a very slippery road that you want to have. You don't want to be there. You really don't want to put yourself in that position. You want your kids to be creative? You want to foster creativity? Have you talked to children? Do you know how creative they are? They will amaze you with all the things that they have in their head without putting literally garbage in it. You will amaze by the things that they can come up with, far more creative than the master pen of any writer you may think of. Do they need for us to lie to them? Do they truly need it? What do we gain? To lose confidence? No. What do we lose? A lot of it. We risk a lot. Think about this. If we teach instead feelings of compassion, of love for each other, if we teach them that beyond the present, beyond the good, there are so much more. There is not magic in Hogwarts or rain or flying reindeers. No, the magic is in the true human spirit that takes us here. We teach them that, we'll accomplish so, so much more. But I'm going to stop.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, lies are of two types. One is dark lie or black lie, another is white lie. our opposition party mentioned lies. Four of them, they mentioned about lies. My opposition first friend, he mentioned, children need to learn the good and to be good. Our children, we cannot characterize them. They are good, they are naughty, they are like this, they are like this. So children sometimes don't know the which one would be harmful, which one would be good for their life. So the parents should manage them. In that case, the Vancouver Sun of Canada, a newspaper, they have surveyed that the Santa Claus is good. That one working mother, she mentioned, Santa Claus, we sometimes say some occasional lie, is much better than telling lie every day to children. My opposition second friend, she said, we have to control our children. Actually, this is not the control. This is the management of our children. We have to manage our children. We have to say that is good for you, that will be good for you, even it's not good, will not be the true in future. Here we are from the society, and here we all of are in an elite society. Mr. Kevin, he did PhD, and there are many PhD students. So there are few PhD holders in the world. So I think all of you have watched the movie Predator, Avatar, Harry Potter. I think you know all of these are fantasies. These are not true. But now you can understand what's the truth. So Santa Claus didn't damage you, didn't harm your life. So finally, I would like to say that Santa is the part of our society, is the part of our culture, not even in the Christian culture, in every culture, because Santa is a symbol, which my first speaker mentioned about it. And in the final remark, I want to say, here, why we came here, because our schoolmasters, they will provide some food. Here, in this debate contest, Santa Claus is our schoolmaster. Thank you.